I recently got an MPC 1000, and I see a lot of people on YouTube with those like videos of how they create samples. Cause I look at those videos to learn how I could better myself on the equipment. So I see a lot of people that really just don't know how to chop samples at all. Like they don't even, they have to have like no kind of musical clue of like time signature and beats and measure or whatever. And that audience is what this video was for. But however, I also see people that know how to chop up samples, like very, very good. But they'll be like, okay, I chopped up these sounds before I recorded the video so I can save time, which is cool. But then they'll be like, well, I don't want to show y'all my secret. But it's really not a secret. It's just, all you did is chop up the sample and put the pads on the beat of the time signature. That's all you really did. So I'm just going to explain how to do that. How to chop up, like you can chop up any sample and make it sound good. But let me play my sample. And I chose the sample because like no one can really rap on it because of the tempo it is. And I was just playing around with it. And I found somebody left this sample on my MPC. And I was on my MPC playing around and I found it. So I'm gonna play this because I don't have a lot of time. But then I'll explain why and how I got it the way that I did. But as you can see, that's just a sample. That's with no keyboard sounds, no synthesizers, no nothing. That's just a sample. Like you could probably lay like some instruments over there and just make it sound that much better. But the point of this video is to show that if you don't really need instruments, like you could just use a sample and make it sound good just by having your sample on beat and on time. So now, this is a good way to think about it. In thermodynamics, the first law is like, matter cannot be created or destroyed and can only be changed in form or some shit like that. The MPC is the same way. What that means is, if I take a stick, you know everything is composed of what, atoms and shit, all matter. So if I burn a stick, and I watch that stick burn in slow motion, and I magnify to where I can see the atoms and burning and turning to ash. If I take the atoms from the ash, I should be able to reconstruct the stick from those atoms, right? That's theory, or not theory, it's law. So the MPC is the same way. The stick is the sample. You burning it by trimming, but the sample is still there, so you still should be able to lay it down on beats. Now how you do that is you take 16, no, you find two measures, you find eight measures out of the sample that you want. And you chop those into 16 parts. So, and of course you have 16 pads per bank. So I'll play my first pad bank. This would be. This is the part that I had planned at the beginning of the video. You see, it sounds very different from how I had it, but see, the good thing about chopping up the samples on beat is that you can chop up. If I would have told you that if I wouldn't have had this MPC and I would have said, okay, that this was a song that somebody created and all I did was just pitch it up, like, you would believe me because my chop was on beat. So it sounded like that matched with the song. So what's to say that this wasn't the song? What's to say that that's not the song? But it's on beat, right? But this is actually the song. See? That's how you want your chops to be. You want your chops to be where you can be so versatile that you can press any pad on that bank and have them matching. So if I wanted to play two pads at the same time, I could do it. I did on the thing. See, you want that to be, you want it to sound like you created it. You want it to sound, even though you didn't create the song, because it is bad enough that we're stealing samples. But you want to make sure that you have your chops in sync with each other. So when you do that, when you find the song that you want. You get eight measures, so you counted eight measures out of that song, and you want to chop them up into 16 different pads. Now, this is how I do it. It's all relative. So if you want to do eight different pads, you'll probably find eight measures out of the song. Four measures out of the song instead of eight, but I do 16. So I find eight measures out of the song, I chop them 16 different pieces, which means I'll have two beats per pad. Now you want to make sure it's a exact eight measures. So just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, all the way till you get to eight. But you gotta count on tempo. Now, as far as laying down sequences go, all I did was I laid down two sequences and I changed small parts in each sequence, and then I just overdubbed other strings and violins from the sample. But it sounds like that's actually a song because my pads are exactly on beat with each other. That's all, like the people that are really like good at sampling that I saw on YouTube, I noticed that's all it really did. They had like, they'd have a drum track and they had the samples just laid down perfectly on beat with each other. Now, if you want to lay down like a very like intricate, tiny part of a sample, still, chop up and have your samples like this first. And then after that, you can still go back and chop up each individual sample and put that on separate pads. So you can put the chops that aren't really on sync with the beat, that are just like a little small phrase out of a measure, you put that in another pad bank. So. But still, you want the bass line and the beat to be there. So that's why you won't have problems with the tempo, you won't have problems with anything. It's just be so easy. So you can just verse. That's two measures. Change a little bit. See, but who's gonna say that the song wasn't originally like that? If I wouldn't have said it, oh, you wouldn't have seen it going. Really what I did. These are sequences. Now all I did to make those strings, I just threw strings over them like this. I threw those strings over the sequence that I had already laid down. So you get something that sounds like somebody did a lot to the sample, they really didn't do that much. It's all about just laying the beat down on a pad evenly. Because of course when you're chopping the sample, the MPC doesn't recognize that you're in 4/4 time, but it's obvious when you're on the main screen on the sequence, you can see that it says time set 4/4. But when you're chopping it, the MPC doesn't recognize that. It recognizes that, okay, this is a sample and I have to chop this into equal parts. So I'm gonna chop it up. If I got five beats, I'm gonna chop it up to 1 1/4 of a beat, 1 1/4 of a beat. And then when you lay that on a pad, you have one and one fourth of a beat on one pad. So then you have to count that in your head, which is harder to count one and one fourth of a beat than it is to count one beat. Feel me? So that's basically it. If you really understand what I'm saying, and you had problems with this before, I'm sure I helped you a lot. But if you really, like, you don't really understand what I'm saying, like, you can ask questions, I'll try to explain it better. Because I see a lot of people that on YouTube, and they leave negative comments on people that's trying to, like, help other people. Even if they said something wrong, they're still trying to help other people. So why are you bashing that person down? He's helping people that he doesn't even know. And he's taking time out of his day to help those people. And you come and leave a negative comment. So, and I see that, so I'm like, I know this, and I see a lot of people with these problems of having tempos. Okay, I know a lot of people know this already, but this is really the basic fundamental of music, like the most basic principle, fundamental principle of music. Like, when you're in the beginner band, you learn about time signature and 4-4 time and 4 beats and bass and all that. That's the first thing you learn before you pick up the instrument. But I see a lot of people that bash and have a problem with this, and I see a lot of people that bash those people. For no reason, like, they're still trying to help people. So I just want to try to help people that probably didn't know this. So if you did, or if you didn't know the relationship, I hope I helped you. And comment, rate, do whatever.